Do you compare Jacinda Ardern with the political environment when you were the leader of the Labor Party and Prime Minister? And do you think you could have achieved your success if you had the same personal life that the Prime Minister currently has, if you were in a de facto relationship, if you indeed you were pregnant?
Well, you might probably too much ancient history even for you, but in 1981, about a month before the election, Peter and I did get married because people said, this is a liability. You are a de facto couple. Now, okay, hey, we're still together, right? We're a very long-running relationship. It didn't matter whether or not we're married. We were going to have a long-term relationship, but you did feel that pressure and you didn't want to do anything to damage your party's prospects or your own prospects and, you know, retaining what was a very safe and loyal Labor constituency. So the social attitudes have moved light years since then, and I think that's a very, very good thing.
So you don't think you could have been Prime Minister if you weren't married?
Oh, look, the issue back then was being elected as the humble MP for Mount Albert, let alone any consideration of being Prime Minister. No one even thought about having a Prime Minister in 1981. Now, I went into Parliament when I was 31.
Yeah.
At 37, I became a minister, very junior minister. I was ranked about 17. Well, here we are. In 2017, Jacinda, at 37, becomes Prime Minister. No, that would not have been possible.
And what about the de facto relationship? Would that have been possible?
I think that would have been impossible for me at 37 trying to be Prime Minister. But I say this is a good thing about New Zealand. That attitudes have changed, more open to younger people, open to younger women, much more tolerant of, you know, you live your life, I live mine. So this is a good thing about our country.
We're not there yet, though. It's interesting to consider the news out this morning that women make up just 18% of senior leadership positions in New Zealand. Of course, we still have a gender pay cap of just under 10%. What do we need to do in order to right those wrongs?
Well, I do think that this issue of being able to combine family and career is a huge issue for women. So we have to have more investment to reach the gold standard of the Scandinavian countries for access to early childhood care and education. Really, nothing matters as much as that. And support for families where both parents are working. You know, that's where women lose those critical years in the career path, which sees the pay gap continue. So it's not until men and women have more similar working lives throughout the life cycle that we will overcome that. Then we just have to make sure that all doors are open. I think with politics now, with 38% of Parliament being women MPs, we can see that 50% within grasp. It's going to take every political party to play ball and play their part in bringing women through their systems. But I think New Zealand can do it. And I do believe that we can be a reference country for what is possible if we keep investing in equality.
Ngā mihi ki a koe. Thanks so much for your time this morning. We really appreciate it. That's former Prime Minister Helen Clark.